Hello, and welcome to Road to Rocheport, the monthly update on the Lance Corporal Leon DeRapp's I-70 Missouri River Bridge. In this month's edition, we'll be talking with Mike Schupp, the construction and materials engineer for this project.
My name is Mike Schupp. I'm the project director for the Rocheport Bridge replacement here at the Boone and Cooper County lines on I-70. We're currently working on the eastbound bridge. We have the westbound bridge done where we have all four lanes of traffic currently. We have completed all the concrete girders for the project, which is basically west of the river to the roadway. So we have all that done. And now back behind me, you see we're starting on our steel girders. This is the first section of girders that will go up. They'll be spliced here on the ground with another section of the girders, and then we'll raise them into place as we go across the river. The difference between the concrete girders and the steel girders is obviously the concrete girders are shorter than the steel girders, so we can span a further distance with the steel girders. That's why they're so tall or deep, we call them. They go as much as 13 foot tall as we get out of that main span where we're spanning between 450 and 475 foot so that river traffic can go up and down the river with a wide opening underneath the bridge. Here we are approaching mid-March, and weather has absolutely been great, so we're making a lot of headway. We're pretty much solely focused right now as far as the steel girders goes. We're focused out in the river. Our biggest problem right now is just low water. We don't have enough water to float the barges, so we're hoping for some spring rains to actually bring that up. We've got about a couple to three more weeks worth of work as far as the piers out in the actual river themselves before we're ready to actually start setting the steel girders, but that time is rapidly approaching. So we were required by the Corps of Engineers and the Coast Guard to have a certain width span actually in the main channel out into the river, which is 450 to 475 feet. So we were required by that, so we basically worked our design around that. You know, we had to also keep a vertical clearance off the water, basically comparable to what the old bridge was, which was the steel truss. So that steel truss bridge was, the deck and the loads were held up by the actual steel truss above the deck. Whereas in a girder bridge like this, the live traffic and the dead load of the bridge is all carried by these girders. So the supports underneath the deck, whereas the old bridge, the supports was above the deck. So, you know, put that steel girders out there, get a tall elevation of a girder, 13 feet, spans a long distance. We'll put these girders together in pieces, set them individually, and then some of them we'll actually pin back together up in the air, and then we'll set them into place and bolt them all together to create a continuous structure all the way across the river. When these bridges were built initially in the 50s and 60s, you know, steel was cheap. You know, that was a preferred choice of materials to build these structures, was out of steel, basically like a Lego system, put them together. It's much more economical as far as time and material to actually do a girder bridge versus a steel truss bridge. Right now, they're taking off the forms off of the top cap off of 12, span or pier 12. So we poured that last week. So it's got strength now, so they're stripping those forms, and they'll put the pedestals up there that the girders actually set on. They'll pour them into place, and then we'll be ready. Once they get strength, we'll be ready to set the steel girders up on top of it. There's still a lot of work to do, but as far as being mid-March, we're really happy with the progression that we've made. We'll start decking this Unit 1 and Unit 2, which is the concrete girder sections of this bridge, and start putting steel in and getting ready to start pouring deck here, hopefully soon, late spring. Yeah, it's starting to shape up really quick. You know, like I said, we don't have, you know, a whole lot of pours left as far as the actual the bents out in the river. So, you know, we've got that where we can count it on 10 fingers. So we're excited about that. Each day that we get a pour done, we know that we're getting that much closer to being able to put those girders up and start decking across the river and coming to a final product.
Thank you for watching. Remember to like, share, and subscribe to MoDOT Central Missouri District on social media for content on this project and more. Until next time, stay safe, remember to buckle up, and put your phones down.